been an Oireachtaí all my life. I liked them all my life from the time I was a 4 year old. They are a different animal to the majority of other pets that people keep, such as dogs. Dogs are more needy, cats are more independent.
I like cats because they're extra special. They have their own personalities, and what you see is what you get. If a cat doesn't like you, it will show it doesn't like you, and if it does, it will be similar. But in the end, they all come round and they show their loyalty and appreciation for everything that you do for them. I think the main thing is you have to treat a cat with respect and be polite at all times. You also have to be prepared to become their slave without you even realising that they've got under your skin. But cats, they will suss you out from the beginning. They do take their time to get to know you, but once they do, you've got a friend for life.
So, moving forward. Pat, could you feed Isolation, please? Jill, could you do the Bobbies?
Yeah.
And Isolation.
Well, spaying and neutering is very important. It is to curb the development of the cat population in general. If you would take a couple of cats, a male and a female, let them get on with business and let all their descendants get on with business, by the time the first pair of cats die of old age, you will have about 48,000 descendants.
Look at her voicing.
Declawing is something we do not do and we do not agree with, ever.
Declawing is not a practice that we here do in the UK at all, and declawing is also a practice that has become illegal in the majority of European states and also in some of American states. It's more something that they do in America where they live very close in apartments and flats, and people are afraid of their furniture getting damaged.
And you're also interfering with the cat's freedom. They climb, how are they supposed to climb if they can't grip onto anything?
Well, we have sob stories and we have happy stories. One, what we would classify as a sob story, for instance, would be an animal that is halfway through a lifespan, but because it reached a certain part in its life, i.e. it might be over 10 years old, the population seeking cats rather prefer younger animals.
My particular one is cats who have been owned by someone since they were kittens. They have grown older with their owner, and the owner has to be taken into hospital or into a home. The family don't want to know the cat, who could be 10, 12 years old by now, suddenly finds itself hitched into a centre surrounded by people it doesn't know, in a place it doesn't know, vying with other cats for attention, and they're just not used to that.
A well looked after cat can live between 18 and 23 years old. Oh, pack it in.
You've also got the story of the laboratory cats that were rescued, who have never known anything but the walls of a lab for their entire lives. They don't know television, they don't know the sound of a hoover, they've never felt rain or snow or wind or anything like that. They're just babies, but they are so trusting despite what they've been through. So the sooner they all get home, the better.
Black cat.
are associated with magic and witches. I have heard that some animal shelters ban adoption around the time of Halloween because people are still of that old mindset when cats were tortured and burned alive at the stake with witches. Yeah, some of the cats think they're admin workers. I mean, we've got a couple of office cats. They will sit in the computer and despite what we say, they decide to take their own thing and email it off to somebody. So that's the main thing. You have to be prepared to share your working day with a cat who thinks he or she knows better than you do.
Cat people. What can we say about cat people and their personalities? A lot of the population conceive cat people to be slightly mad because the majority of people that do or keep cats keep more than one. I think cat people are a very a nice group of the population that see life a little bit less stressful than, say, for instance, a dog owner.
Who wouldn't want to come into work in the morning and be surrounded by furry bodies? It's absolutely wonderful. And we're helping cats in need get the forever home that they so deserve.
Whereas in some jobs, you get up in the morning and says, oh, please, not today. I never experienced that in the 10 years that I work with Cats Protection.